Hey, hello and welcome back to my channel, guys. I am Vagisha and today I am going to share my thoughts and opinions on the national costume competition of Miss Grand International. So I haven't watched this event before, so I'm doing the live commentary here on the event. So without further ado, let's get started. So Angola is the first one to make it to the national costume competition of Miss Grand International. I love her energy. She is superb on stage. I mean, I really get goosebumps the way she is handling her eyes, her expressions, and even her body language. It's fierce and ferocious. Love it. I really love the fact that through national costume competition, we get to experience so many cultures and so many traditions which otherwise we overlook to see. And the pageants, I would say, are just a beautiful reflection of having a connection with different cultures which we never have interacted with. The next up in line is Argentina. We have seen this kind of costume for Argentina in many of the previous editions of Miss Universe pageant, and here also it gives a very carnivalesque kind of vibes. Up next we have Armenia. I really love the explanation that it is headed with four elements, and that's why I love these national costume rounds, because they are very meaningful. They have some significant meanings of respective cultures hidden in these beautiful costumes. I love her grace, how she's proudly representing her culture on the stage. First of all, I have to appreciate the fact that Miss Grand International pageant never disappoints with the stage setup and the music and everything. The choreography, the direction, everything seems on point. Miss Grand Australia is stunning. I love the costume she is wearing. The beautiful butterfly wings make her look like one. I love her. And we have to appreciate the fact that she is so much well in shape. I cannot wait to see her preliminary competition performance. Now we next have Bangladesh. This beautiful costume talks about the independence of Bangladesh, and it looks simple yet it indicates a message, and that's why we have national costume rounds, right? Although I'm not a fan of the dress which she's wearing. I think it's quite ill-fitted. They could have done a better job with the fittings of this costume. It looks a little bit out of the place, and maybe that's why she does not look that comfortable. We have Belgium. If you look at her costume, I think these are the postcard stamps on her costume. She's acting like a puppet. Okay, they have a cartoon character and she's just imitating that character. It's a cute one, I would say, and she did a fair job in executing this costume. The crowd is really cheering for her, and I don't know how many of you have watched this movie called Paheli. There's a song, and when we were quite young, we used to see the song, and it had certain puppet like steps and moves, and it reminds me of the same. I love this costume. I love the headgear here. It has the inscription of certain tribal god maybe, and Bolivia's carnivalous culture is clearly visible through this costume. She looks super sexy. We have to appreciate her modelless figure. She's very sexy. Look at that, Miss Grand Brazil. I have never seen Brazil executing any costume like this. This is a mythic character talking about a story of a snake, and I love the scales and the fierce vibe which this costume is creating. Love the way how Brazil is executing it, the way she is gliding on the stage. Showcases that a snake is effortless to just crawl, you know, in a very gliding way. She's sexy. I love her gaze. It's not too over the top and it's not very subtle either. Miss Grand Cambodia is here, and I love the fact that she is showcasing the written languages through this costume. I love the grace, you know, whenever you look at Miss Grand Cambodia, she's always smiling, be it the welcome ceremony, be it the swimsuit competition. And look at the surprise factor here. It's also highlighting the Angkor Wat. I think this particular place was showcased in the last edition of Miss Universe Cambodia's national costume. So it's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Canada's costume is vibrant. The color red already gives me so much of vibrance and vitality. And the fact that she chooses to talk about Canadian women through this costume really is quite exciting. She sounds very powerful with those gestures, and I love the way she executes it. We have Chili here. I love the fact that she is wearing the headgear with the feathers of the colors which are there in their flag, and even her costume carries the similar kind of colors which they have in the flag. I love the boots. They are very beautiful, very I would say filled with details. The gold color, the tiny details which we see there, that makes me want to have a closer look at those boots. And she looks beautiful. She's stunning. Although I was expecting a little bit of more expressions. I mean, she seems quite lost here in the moment. She's not smiling. She's not showcasing any expression on her face. That's the only thing that bothers me. Coming to Colombia, oh my God, I love Colombia. And she's already doing great in other pre-pageant activities. And here also, I'm amazed with the kind of exuberance she has brought on the stage. If you look at the headgear, it's beautiful. And it reflects the ocean. The way she's moving on the stage is also indicative of the fact how the waves glide through its shores. I love the detailing of the blouse which she's wearing, and also the costume which she's wearing. If you have a closer look at it, you will be surprised by the kind of gems and stones which have been used in this costume. It's lovely. And also love the grace. You know, I'm in love with this woman. Aha, we have Costa Rica. It's a beautiful costume. And it showcases the feathers of the peacock. She is imitating a peacock. Wow. So the peacock resembles the power of the nation. And if you look at the walk, she is certainly showcasing the power while gliding like a peacock. You know, she's just dancing like a peacock. So that's beautiful. Another beautiful costume. Cuba. You have to look at this woman. I mean, the way she nailed the swimsuit competition is something. I won't be surprised if she makes it to the top five. Although this is the national costume round and it does not really count. But you know, the stage presence which she brings in to the picture every time she walks in, that makes me want to see more and more of her. Her body is sleek. She's very good on the runway. She kills it with her expressions. So overall, I'm in love with her personality. Ah, that is a surprise twist. She is holding the flag. Lovely. This costume is lovely. Curacao. I really had this in my mind the moment she walked on the stage. Is she replicating a windmill? And that's what her costume stands for. So it's really good that the contestants are coming out of box, thinking about the ideas which are not limited and pretty obvious to be interpreted, but they're coming up with something more meaningful, more powerful, and it gives us an idea of how they're evolving as countries. So lovely costume again. Czech Republic has a very adventurous and mysterious kind of costume. She's wearing a beautiful mask. If you look at the costume, you know, the details have been worked upon with a lot of effort. Even the mask, the net is woven in such a way that it looks quite intricate. Beautiful. I don't have words, you know, to say that this costume is something which is class apart. It's not the usual costume which you see. Oh my God, we have a winner here till now. Dominican Republic. Oh my God. Look at that. I'm already terrified with awe, you know, and wonder with. I was lost in the moment. You know, if you look at the headgear, I don't know what you people call it, but the headgear also contains a musical instrument, and it is called damru in Hindi. So the way she's carrying it, you know, this costume has a lot of interpretations, a lot of meaning, and even the colors which have been used here, they have been used very wisely and intelligently. So it really evokes the feeling of terror, yet at the same time awe in my mind. And it somehow reminds me of William Blake's poem, The Tiger, which arises the terror and awe at the same time in the person who speculates, who visualizes a tiger. The same thing is happening with me here when I look at this costume. I like this one. Just when I thought that we couldn't have a better one, we have Ecuador here. Look at that costume. The way she has hung two baskets besides her thighs, it's really something. Wow, look at the jewels she has adorned her body with. The makeup on her forehead and eyes is intricate. We have to say that a lot of work has been done on this costume, and she is doing it so effortlessly. She's carrying this costume so effortlessly. I love how it has been executed on the stage, and it's not easy at all to bring such a huge costume on the stage and still be able to do justice with it. Good job. We have Egypt here. Again, a very good costume from Egypt, because we have not really seen Egypt presenting quite huge costumes on any of the international pageants. So this is something unusual which we are seeing here. She has brought a tiger on the stage, and she is replicating a sky god here. So this is a good one, a good costume. I mean, when you watch the national costume competition, you know, you cannot narrow down your choices on who is the best and who is the worst. I think that would be really unfair to say so. And this is a beautiful surprise. If you see here, Egypt, you know, the headgear has opened just when I thought that it is not that intricate. It unfolded into so many other things. We have El Salvador here. It's a simple and pretty costume. I love what she is holding in the hands. Very carnivalesque. We have France here. So basically, this costume does not reflect anything cultural, but it's taken from an everyday look. So France is always known for fashion and different kind of culture which are presented in the fashion shows. So we could say that this is a smart choice, but maybe more effort could be poured in. Anyway, we have Germany here. We have seen quite a similar costumes of Germany at Dances of the World in Miss World competition. And the contestants who present the same culture, they also come across as dancing in the similar way. So this is a good costume. Carrying the basket and walking very carefree, in a very carefree manner on the stage. It's lovely. You know, if you look at her costume, I don't know how many of you have actually read this poem by Christina Rossetti, Goblin Market. So Germany's costume remind me of that. Wow, Guatemala's costume is also wonderful, exuberant, very vibrant. The jewelry which she's wearing and the costume, the headgear, it reflects the beauty of the country, the culture, and it's very, very colorful. Yeah, I love this costume by Haiti. If you have heard Haiti talk, you know, you would be a fan of her eloquence. She is an underdog here, and she must be given attention. Nonetheless, coming to her costume, I think she's doing a fabulous job in handling this lovely costume. I like how she's carrying it. I love the fact that they are throwing attention on food and how this natural food is harvested by people's effort, and it shows abundance for the coming life. We have another beautiful costume here by Honduras. Look at the makeup she has done. I don't know whether it's a mask. We have not got the closer look yet. But look at the costume, it's so grand. Just like the pageant which stands for the grandeur, this costume is grand. Yes, it's not a mask, it's beautiful makeup which has been done on the face. Beautiful. Magnificent, I would say. We have Miss Grand Hong Kong, and Hong Kong has been the talk of the town since day one for her funny and over the top kind of expressions on the stage. And here also, if you look at her costume, you know, she is reflecting dim sums, and it's a funny but cute representation of the cuisine of Hong Kong. Lovely. Oh wow, we have Miss Grand India. Look at the headgear. I love Manika Shukant. You know, she has been a major revelation in all the days of Miss Grand International. I'm really looking forward to her prelims performance. She's filled with energy, and this is the fact which I love for her, because she has evolved so beautifully. In her national pageant, I was not very sure about her energy, but if you look at her, you know, she has evolved leaps and bounds. Indonesia always comes up with a unique costume. This time as well, they have come up with a great costume here. Although, you know, we have been so habitual of looking at the grand costume sent by Indonesia, that this lovely costume is also quite awe-striking, but I still expected a quite grand costume from their country. Nonetheless, she is wonderful on the stage. I really have high hopes from Miss Grand Indonesia, and I won't be surprised if she lands her place in top 3 or maybe even end up winning the crown. Love the representation. We have Italy. Like this costume. It's very different, quite unique. She looks like a sci-fi character who has just come out of any great movie, you know. Recently, I ended up watching this series called Hellbound, and if I look at her, she somehow reminds me of the graphics which we have in that series. We have Miss Grand Japan here. I was super impressed by Japan in the swimsuit round, and hence I would wait for her prelims performance, because although she cannot speak that well, but Miss Grand is not only about speaking, so I'm giving her that privilege of advancing further if she does well in the prelims. This costume is beautiful, simple, and it does the justice to her country. The orchids are very much evocative of the Japanese culture, which we see at Miss International pageants as well. We have Korea, and Korean culture, the traditional Korean culture, is beautifully reflected in this lovely costume. I love the whole costume which she's wearing. There is a traditional name of the costume, I'm not able to recall it, but it reflects the culture so beautifully. If you look at her face, you know, you'll be reminded of all the cultural dances which they have, and the queenly expression which these artists have on their face while they're executing the same, and it's quite grand. Look at the headgear, the crown sort of headgear. It has so many jewels and precious stones. I love this costume. Look at Laos. Beautiful, beautiful. So till now, I love Dominican Republic and Laos. I'm sure that there's a surprise awaiting us when she reaches the head rim. And I think that's gonna happen. She's going to open it. And I'm so excited to see what's there. Beautiful. It's a platter sort of thing. Lovely. We have Liberia here. Love her aura. She is so exotic. I love the jewels, the stones which she's wearing here in the one suit. It's quite good. I'm sure we are waiting for the Philippines. Look at this costume. This is a winning costume, man. Malaysia has killed it. Wow. So this is a hailing ritual for the fishermen. And I love the way it has been executed. This is not easy to bring it to an international pageant. This huge costume must have been accumulated so well. Loved it. Malaysia is gonna do wonders in the coming days. I have a feeling. We have Mauritius here. I like the blue color, and again it talks about being the protector of the sea. If you look at the details of the costume, it's beautiful. It has the fin-like feature reflecting the sea life of Mauritius, and if you look at the costume, the detailing, you know, it's quite beautiful. And the way it has been handled by her, I love the way she is so graceful. We have Mexico. Anytime I see a carnival, you know, I'm always reminded of the Latin American country. So please do not kill me if I again use this word carnival. It reminds me of the carnival feature which we are often used to seeing in the Latin American countries, especially during the winters and the New Year celebration during the holidays. So I really love this. You know, if you look at the costume, somehow it is like Brazil, so you can say that these two costumes are a little bit similar, although Mexico has an additional touch with the snake or the dinosaur which she's wearing here. I believe it's to be a snake. We have Myanmar. beautiful costume. I love the trail which she has at the back of the costume. It's beautiful. I want to have a closer look at the trail. I love what she's holding here in her hand. Beautiful. Very intricate details are there in her blouse and in the waistband which she's wearing. Lovely. And the headrem pose are very elegant and graceful, very sophisticated. We have Nepal with us, and I really love the fact that how India and Nepal are both quite similar in their cultures and yet so different and wonderfully different, you know. So I love the color which she's wearing. It's quite indicative of the culture which Nepal has. Next up, we have Netherlands. Netherlands costume reminds me of the F1 race. It's quite sporty and she looks beautiful. I definitely have my eyes on her. Her walk is beautiful and she does perform well. And she did stand out in many of the pre-pageant activities. So I'm really keen on to see what she has to offer. Lovely. Now we have Nicaragua. I have seen the similar costume many times at Miss Universe. I'm sure that we all must have seen this kind of costume. It's beautiful and reminds me of the grandeur which the country has. And this pre-Hispanic clothing has a lot of intricate details. If you look at the costume, prop she is holding in her hand, it is beautiful. The crown has a lot of intricate details. Next we have Miss Grand Nigeria. I love the way she is executing the costume on the stage. Love her walk and beautiful costume. She looks very beautiful. So this beautiful costume has the message of giving peace to all the people here, and it aligns pretty well with the theme of Miss Grand International, Stop the War and Promote the Peace. Oh, we have to say that all the costumes which we have seen till now, Angola's costume might not be quite extravagant, but the way she executed it on the stage, that has to be commendable. Anyway, coming back to Northern Ireland, she looks beautiful here. We have Miss Grand Pakistan, and it's a beautiful lehenga which she's wearing, and it throws light on the ecosystem of Pakistan. I'm not exactly sure how the costume is convincingly showcasing the ecosystem, but nonetheless, she looks like a model of, let's say, you know, Lakme Fashion Week. She looks nice here. Another beautiful costume by Panama. If you remember her swimsuit competition, she was quite good here. And even today, she looks very vibrant, energetic, and at the same time jovial. Again, a very carnivalous kind of costume here, which showcases the beauty of the Latin American country. I love these vibrant colors, you know, like red, yellow. They're very vibrant and it just catches you in the eyes. We have Miss Grand Paraguay. You know, Paraguay is winning Miss Grand International once has made us realize that now Paraguay is quite serious of sending worthy candidates to the pageant. If you look at the national costume of Miss Grand Paraguay here, it's beautiful. It has a lot of intricate details, both in the wings, you could say, you know, at the backdrop of the costume, and even the costume itself is quite grand in the nature. The jewels, the stones have been very intricately put up there. And she looks beautiful, and it also has a beautiful message, you know, respect, love, tolerance and peace. And the rainbow color, I'm not sure whether it is indicative of the culture or maybe the inclusiveness of the worldwide peace which we want to have. Peru walks here with a beautiful costume. Since day one, I have always loved Peru. I'm not very happy why she is not that fit to compete in the swimsuit round. Here she looks great, but you know, I wanted her to be absolutely best when she comes for the pageant. So I'm still waiting for the prelims to happen, but I do see her placing maybe in the top 20. I love the execution of this costume. She looks very grand. It's beautiful costume. Another lovely costume by Philippines. This is indicative of the popular festival which they have in the Philippines. Samantha looks so gorgeous here. You can see her beautiful face. She is very comfortable. She is very confident. And she is reflecting the beauty of Philippines in a very unique way. Till the costumes which we have seen for the Philippines in different international pageants till now, this one is pretty unique because, you know, even if the light goes dim here, the nerves in the butterfly's wing, you know, they are reflecting the color of the Filipino flag, the red and blue color. Beautiful. I love the presentation of Portugal. Very simple costume, but love the energy and vibrance she has. Good. Oh my god, this girl is my favorite. Puerto Rico is here. I love the exuberant costume. It's so grand. I love the color. This queen is very graceful and regal. She's very royal. I mean, she can just work wonders with any costume, any dress, at any of the pre-pageant activity, you know, be it swimsuit, be it the national costume round, or any other pre-pageant activity. I just see her hanging out and she simply mesmerizes me with her charm. She is very elegant and I definitely have my eyes on her. I cannot wait to see her in the prelims and possibly win Miss Grand International. So we have Russia here. She is beautiful and it reflects the butterfly. She is very elegant and graceful. We have Siberia here. Siberia looks like a queen. She reminds me of a mythological figure, somehow like a character from, let's say, Aladdin's movie. So she looks very elegant and a figure from the fictional world. And she is quite magical with her costume. South Africa is there. South Africa is wearing a beautiful costume. Very beautiful costume. The prop she is holding is quite powerful, very magnificent. If you look at the detailing of the costume, it's done with a lot of effort. I like the choice of the lip color which she's wearing. It's very unusual. And if you look at the trail of the costume, it has the faces of many interesting and significant figures in her country. So it's a very well thought and well executed costume, and I definitely have high hopes from this lady. Beautiful costume again. We have Spania. Look at that. Beautiful. She looks like a doll. You know, I am so amazed by the different kind of costumes these candidates have brought on the stage. And this time, because of the COVID restrictions, not many countries are participating, but that does not make the pageant any less. And it's not only about Miss Grand International, all the other pageants which are happening parallelly and simultaneously. I love the fact that despite of the negativity around the whole world because of the pandemic, these candidates have come forward with complete enthusiasm and vigor and given us yet another chance to appreciate beauty, solidarity across various cultures in all enthusiasm. That is beautiful. Again, a beautiful costume here. It's Sri Lanka. I love the detailing of the costume which she is wearing. And I definitely want to have a closer look. I think it has the beads and the pearls. And since Sri Lanka belongs to the coast, remember, leave it down in the comments. It's the snowy reflection of the country. Next up, we have Thailand. I am so excited for Thailand every time Thailand makes it to the NATCOS. Look at that. Extraordinary beautiful. Wow. Oh my god, this is a potential winning costume here. Again, I have already said that we don't have any winners or losers in the national costume, but this costume stands out. It stands out so beautifully. And it reflects the cultural heritage of Thailand in such a lovely way. It's very strong and powerful representation. The boots, the costume, the prop she's holding, the headgear. Everything is filled with tiny details, and look at those jewels and the gemstones. It's lovely. We have United States of America. She looks like a Barbie, and through this costume, she intends to raise awareness for the breast cancer, and it's a powerful costume. It gives a very powerful message. And now I think we are left only with Venezuela and Vietnam. So let's see what they have to showcase. I can't wait to see Venezuela. Venezuela has a beautiful haircut, and I don't know whether she's going to don it today or not. So let's see. Venezuela's costume is outstanding. Oh my god, look at the black snake thing which she has on her hand. I mean, it looks so real. It is already giving me so much goosebumps. If you look at the right and the left side of the costume, it reflects the beauty at the one hand, but terror and fierceness also on the other. I love the headgear. I love the execution, the representation. I definitely see Venezuela doing extremely well in the days to come. I love the braid which she has. And lastly, we have Vietnam. She looks very cute doing the gestures on the stage. I love her beautiful face. She has that innocent charm on her face, and that makes me want to see her more and more. I like the subtle color. It's beautiful. I mean, this color is such a beautiful color that if you wear it in any pageant activity, you know, you will shine. Look at the back of the costume. It's beautiful. So this costume says that COVID-19, it's time for you to leave. And look at the LED lights which she has in between the wings. It makes it look more beautiful when the light goes dim. So on and on, look at the stage, look at the choreography. I was super impressed with the national costume competition. I never wanted it to end, but here we are towards the end of the ceremony. So on the 3rd of December, probably we are going to have the prelims of Miss Grand, and I just cannot wait to share my thoughts on the same with you all. So stay tuned for more updates on different pageants. I'm going to do more head-to-head challenge reviews on Miss World, and I would be coming up with my reviews on Miss Universe. So stay tuned for that, and also let me know in the comments what else you would like to see in the coming weeks, since it's the pageant season going on. I'll be covering all the pageants which are happening right now parallelly. So the generic topics will be covered later on after the pageant season is done. And right now I'll be just reviewing all of these. So thank you for watching. It was great to share my thoughts with all of you. Do share in the comment section which was your favorite national costume in the national costume competition of Miss Grand International. Until next time, I'll see you guys super soon with a new one. Thank you. Bye-bye.